In this video, we'll get to know how we can move, rotate, and scale objects in Unity Visual Scripting through exploring all the nodes Unity offers for working with the Transform component. If you are new to Unity Visual Scripting, I recommend checking out the Getting Started video. When working with game objects, we want to move and change them by accessing the Transform component's properties. To access the position of a game object in the world, we use the GetPosition node. To modify it, we will use the SetPosition node. We can use the GetLossyScale node to get the object's actual size. When we want to rotate an object, we have the GetAndSetRollerAngle nodes. We can retrieve and modify the object's rotation angle through them. If we want to increase or decrease the existing rotation angle, we can use the TransformRotate node. It also allows us to configure the Relative To option, which we can set to World or Self, determining whether to rotate the object relative to itself or to the parent game object it is under. Using 3D cubes nested in each other, we can observe the different values we get by toggling from World to Self. When we nest objects in the hierarchy, we refer to them as parent and child. Speaking of parent and child game objects, we have access to various nodes dedicated to controlling the object's hierarchy. In some cases, we will set a game object as a child affected by its parent, such as the case of a tank's turret. We want the turret to rotate and move along the tank's body, so we'll set it as a child of the body object. Back in the graph, we use the get and set parent node to control the object's parent and retrieve it. We got another node for setting the parent, set parent world position stays node. And with it, as its name suggests, we can choose to retain the object's world position, rotation, and scale when changing the parent. A parent object may have multiple children. We can ask for a specific child using the getChild node or count them with the getChildCount node. Combining these nodes with the for loop node, we access all the parent's children. Finally, the detached children node allows us to disconnect all the parent's child game objects. We already know we can get and set the different properties of the transform component. We can also transform game objects relative to their parent. We can use nodes similar to those we met earlier. Get and set local position nodes, get and set local scale nodes, and get and set local Euler angles nodes. These nodes differ from the previous nodes we learned about in such they are retrieving or changing the properties based on the parent. For example, get local position provides us the distance from the parent instead of the position in the world. Moving a game object is a fundamental part of creating any game in Unity, and as such, there are many ways to do so. We will cover quite a few in our videos, but for now, let me introduce you to the Translate node. This node moves a game object in the direction and the distance based on the translation input. It's a shortcut for a graph built of getPosition and add nodes connected to the setPosition. Speaking of moving objects, you can also move your cursor and hit the like button. Another valuable node is LookAt. With this node, we can rotate to follow another game object as it moves. Let's say we want this camera to follow this sphere. We add a script graph to the camera game object and connect the update event to the LookAt node. To the target input, we attach the sphere game object by using the game object find node. We can now move the sphere when playing the game, and the camera will follow it around. We can get the direction axis, the transform faces, with the getUp, getRight, and getForward nodes. The getUp node is for the green arrow, getRight is for the red arrow, and the getForward is for the blue arrow. When it comes to controlling the movement direction of a game object, these nodes come in handy. In this example, connecting the getUp node to the translate node will move the object one unit in the direction of the green arrow. And that's it! Thank you for following along.